Hello, beautiful souls. Sherry here from No Fucks Given Crew. How's it going? So this is going to be a divine masculine reading for April the 4th until the 11th, 2017. So I'm using the John Holland Psychic Tarot. And please remember that this is a general reading, so it may not resonate with everyone. I also want to thank you guys so much for the support that you've given me. It means a lot to have you on my journey. Much love. Okay. So I'm also going to be using my cards for clarification. So I'm using the John Holland for the main energy, and then three cards per position for clarification. And then I will also pull two cards from Call It Baron Reed, Enchanted Map. So beginning with, I'm going to be doing Celtic Wing if I didn't mention that already. So present position. Light. So this is the best major arcana to have. It represents a brand new beginning. It is a return to your innocence, seeing life through a child's eyes. And this card represents energy coming towards you, your dreams being realized. But it is more of an illumination, coming into a higher state of consciousness. The Sun card also represents masculine energy, so you're standing in your masculine, fiery, passionate energy. Eight of Cups, Nine of Swords, Fool card. So the Eight of Cups showed up in the past position for both the masculine and the feminine. So this is an energy of walking away from negative people and situations that are draining you, emotionally draining you. And it's making that decision to let that energy go. And it's a spiritual quest to find yourself. So pilgrimage, present position, you feel that you are on this journey, this mission to find yourself. The Nine of Swords also is a repeated card, showed up twice in the Twin Flame reading. Nine of Swords is feeling like you are trapped by the mind, by fear. It's a sense of not being able to sleep, having nightmares, anxiety, and stress. But it's a nine, which means that it's ending of that cycle, releasing those negative thoughts, those self-limiting beliefs. And starting a new life. The Fool card is 0 point. It's starting from scratch and seeing the world through a child's eyes. So it's taking that leap of faith, trusting in destiny, but not having any expectations or attachments to the outcome. It is walking away from that which no longer serves you, releasing yourself from that mental prison and moving towards the sun, towards your higher calling, your destiny. Foundation, positive movement forward, the Eight of Pentacles. So this is a grounding energy. It is a solid foundation has been laid in the 3D world. You built up a wealth for yourself, and you're continuing to build upon that. But more importantly, this represents moving towards the sun, towards your destiny, and feeling successful as a result of it. Magician, Four of Cups, and Five of Pentacles. So, magician, the master manifester, creating your reality. You have the power to sculpt your environment as you see fit. So it's a realization that you are in control of how your movie plays out. So it is pulling energy from source, those ideas, and making them a reality. And that's further grounded with this Eight of Pentacles. It's like you've already been working on manifesting your dreams and you feel successful about it. And it's because you have this free flowing energy. You know, you're receiving inspiration and grounding that into reality. You are the master manifester. The Four of Cups is stagnation, feeling like things aren't moving fast enough. It's a longing, wanting energy. And then the Five of Pentacles is feeling left out in the cold, like you need to shoot yourself in the foot in order to release yourself from a situation which will result in a financial loss of some kind. So, you know, this positive movement forward came with sacrifices. And, you know, it's causing a sense of disconnect, but ultimately it's movement forward, grounding your dreams and wishes into reality and making it happen, but accepting those losses and continuing to move forward. Recent past position, shadow, facing your fears head on, letting go of negative thoughts, self-limiting beliefs, the cage, the mental cage, and, you know, feeling like you're not good enough and that you're trapped. So it's facing your shadow aspect and moving through that veil of darkness. Ace of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles, and Two of Wands. So the Ace of Pentacles is planting that seed in the 3D. It's a brand new beginning in the 3D. So the seed has already been planted, and you made a decision to move forward with this grounding energy, this new start with the Two of Pentacles and the Two of Wands. So the pentacle energy is the wind of change, and it is being resilient and flexible while this change occurs. The Two of Wands is a spiritual card. It is realizing your higher dreams, your higher visions, expanding your mind and making decisions that aren't based on fear but on your higher spiritual, higher self, your higher destiny. So, new start, decision made to walk away from negative energy. It's a rebirth. From the moon came the sun and a new beginning, pilgrimage to find yourself, your truth. So it's almost like that key was handed to the masculine. He took that key, unlocked the door, and was reborn. As an outcome you desire, triumph, the Chariot. It is movement forward towards your destiny, towards that thing that makes you happy. This is a water card, which is emotions. But it's taking those reins and steering yourself towards that, using your pure will. Ace of Swords, Six of Pentacles, and Moon. So Ace of Swords is cutting through the darkness, through the barriers, grounding your truth into reality, making a decision based on your truth and being unwavering. This also represents triumph and success, just as this card is triumph. So there's a lot of victory in your future. You desire to move towards your goals and make them a reality. And because of that decision to do so, then that reality is manifested. The Six of Pentacles is the cohabitation card. It is coming together and sharing your life with somebody in the 3D. And then the Moon card, once again, it is what was once dark is now illuminated. What was impossible is now possible. It's seeing beyond the veil to the truth. And what's that truth? It is that thing that makes you come alive. and happy. So there's a sense that the masculine has made a decision, cut through the darkness, and wants a union in the 3D and would like to move forward, and is likely to do that if he stays on that path. Crossroads position, spiritual union. So this is seeing your true love, recognizing your soulmate and wanting to be with your soulmate, making that decision to share your life with her. And this union is based on love. See all the green? Your heart chakras are open and you're connected through the third eye and the crown chakra. So it's this beautiful exchange of energy that you share between the two of you. You help each other to grow, not only in the 3D, but spiritually. Five of Cups, Seven of Wands, and the High Priest. So the Five of Cups is emotional loss. This energy came up on the Divine Feminine side, feeling sad, wanting to be in union with her masculine, but feeling as though things aren't working out the way she wants them to, and it's causing sadness. The Seven of Wands also came up in the Twin Flame Union. It is standing up for your beliefs and making those things happen, not backing down, finding your power to make what you want happen. The Wand energy is spirit, so it has to do with your higher calling, the spiritual union. The High Priest is you in the 5D spiritual form. This union is awakening you on, you know, higher and higher levels of consciousness. Here you being represented as having your crown chakra open. So it is confirmation that this union is helping you to, you know, awaken to your higher self. So this crossroads position, wanting union, wanting to be with your feminine, but feeling pain and loss because you can't. And spirit is asking you to find that strength within you in order to, you know, speak your truth and stand up for your core values and your desires, but ultimately connect with your higher self. What are you resisting? Disruption, the tower. But you can't stop the tower. It's coming whether you like it or not. So the tower is a sudden change. It comes in like a bolt of lightning, and it changes your world forever. It tears down the fake, the false, the lies in the 3D world, in the material world. That false foundation that you built up is crumbling. And although there's a sense that you're resisting it, the tower will come down. And spirit is asking you to be the consciousness behind the tower, allowing it to fall. The Wheel of Fortune, the Queen of Wands, and the Hangman. So the Wheel of Fortune represents change. And it represents karma coming back to you in a good way. It's good luck, good fortune, and it's completion of a cycle, 5 to 10 years. So this change happens whether you like it or not. Once again, confirmation. And spirit is asking you to let go of control, see things from a different perspective, from a higher level, and allow, let go of control and surrender without any involvement with you. You be the conscious observer, like I said. The Queen of Wands is the object of your desire. She represents that fiery passion within you. So, what I'm feeling is that this Queen is bringing in change and awakening you to a different perspective, a higher consciousness, which ultimately requires the Tower to tear down the falsehoods, the lies. And these two cards are saying that it's happening whether you like it or not. And instead of fighting it, resisting it, to surrender and allow. Your internal environment. Four swords. You retreated from the negative energy, the negative thoughts, and you found peace and stillness in your mind and in your heart. And you are healing yourself. And you're doing that in order to make decisions about the 3D world. But currently you're at a peaceful state. Page of Swords, the Page of Wands, and the King of Swords. So the Page of Swords is a double communicator. He's a messenger, and so is this page, so they are both communication messages coming in. This one has to do with speaking your truth. Swords are also communication, so it is speaking your truth on a massive level. So it's mental clarity that is arising as a result of this stillness in your mind, and it's wanting to communicate that truth. The Page of Wands is good news. It could be coming in towards you, or you would like to express that, communicate that. So it could also represent that while you're in the stillness, perhaps you are getting messages from spirit, from your higher self, synchronicities, messages from the divine that are helping you find clarity and connect you to your higher vision, your higher self. This is gasoline being poured on a fire. It is a movement towards your destiny, or it is a realization of that. It's an inspiration, a spark. It's like an aha moment. And this is mental clarity about that aha moment, that spark that sets you ablaze. The King of Swords is an air sign, or it could represent you as the divine masculine coming into mental clarity and taking control of yourself and your thoughts. It is cutting away emotional people and situations, and like being disconnected from that, finding peace and stillness and mental control in order to find strength within yourself to make decisions. So you are definitely doing your work. You're connecting on a spiritual level, and as well as letting go of mental noise that is holding you back. But again, there's a sense that you're still resisting that tower. You're still afraid of it. Your outcome, solitude, the hermit. There's a feminine energy being represented here. So perhaps the feminine has disconnected in order to find herself, find her inner light. Or perhaps she's holding the Book of Knowledge open for you to read, to discover for yourself what your truth is, and showing you your light within, guiding you. Justice, Nine of Cups, and the King of Cups. So justice is truth. It's the number 11. It is balance. And it's karma coming back to you in a good way, but it is a cause and effect. So what you put out, you get back, and karma is coming back in a good way. Nine of Cups is wish granted, wish fulfilled on an emotional level, feeling an abundance of love and being excited about it and celebrating it, and you know, finally arriving at that point where you can enjoy your life and go out to restaurants and just be happy all the time. The King of Cups, this is you as a divine masculine, really connecting to your heart chakra, feeling love, unconditional love, being open to receiving and giving love on a very deep level. So a definite emotional connection resulting from spiritual growth. And it is love that fuels the evolution of consciousness. Only through love can you fully awaken to those higher levels. And if you refuse to open your heart chakra and let people in, then you stay disconnected. Although you feel safe, you don't really truly experience life, you know, what it has to offer. The external environment, star card, wish granted again. You wished upon a star, and those wishes are coming true. So, because it's an external energy, it's coming from the feminine. She's offering this healing energy. She's showing you how beautiful you are, that beautiful star in the sky. She holds you in her hands, in her arms, and loves you, is offering you a safe place to heal yourself and giving you unconditional love. So this card appears after a very difficult time, and you have come through that darkness into the light, and it is time for you to heal your heart and then open it, allow love in. Knight of Pentacles, Strength card, Queen of Cups. Confirmation that it is the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Love, the Divine Feminine, who is holding this safe place for you. She gives you unconditional love. She is an open vessel. She is also intuitive and connected to her inner knowing. So this love comes without strings. The Knight of Pentacles is my favorite knight. It is taking that one step at a time, making your dreams a reality. And when the knight shows up, it generally means that he's about to take that last step into the 3D world and make his dreams manifest. The Strength card is using love, kindness, and compassion in order to deal with situations and people. But it is this love and this openness of the Queen, holding this gentle light in her hands, that is drawing you towards her, towards the light, towards your truth. You're following your heart. Summary outcome, firm foundation, Four Pentacles. So, you know, this could represent you being closed off, not allowing anyone in, protecting your heart, or holding on to material possessions too tightly. It could also represent that a firm foundation has been laid. This love, this spiritual union is grounded. Five of Wands, Three of Pentacles, and wow, Twin Flame card. Confirmation that this reading is about a Twin Flame connection that is grounded into the 3D reality, spiritual union. Summary of the reading. Whoa. Okay. It's domino, so I won't touch it. So the Five of Wands is obstacles and challenges. It's a difference of opinion. You're met with a challenge, and this energy is meant to make your light shine brighter. So it's just a small obstacle that must be overcome. The Three of Pentacles tells me that you've overcome that obstacle, and you have grounded this union into the 3D. So it is that initial feeling of abundance or return as a result of the work that you've already done. But there's still more work to do, but it's confirmation that you're successful in grounding a foundation. And what is that thing that you've worked so hard to ground into reality? It is the twin flame union, twin flame connection, recognition that you've found your twin, you recognize your reflection, your mirror, and now you want to ground that, and it is being grounded. You want to connect with your divine feminine in the 3D. Okay, final outcome. Wow. I'm saying wow because I had this vision in my mind earlier. For some reason, I saw the divine feminine as the final outcome. And I've had that thought all day. It's just really strange that it's now showing up in the masculine reading. I expected it so many other times today. It's just bizarre. This is so beautiful. I don't even want to pull additional clarifiers for it. Here is the divine feminine, your destiny. She's standing there on the, you know, edge of possibilities, open and accepting and, you know, holding you gently in her arms. Heart chakra opens, this is earth energy. So the masculine is providing that foundation, the feminine is that movement towards that destiny, that desire ultimately is to connect with the feminine. Nine of Wands, Queen of Swords, and Completion. Nine of Wands is the wounded warrior feeling like you want to give up and walk away. Beaten up, battle wounds, scars. You don't want to go on, but at the core, you know you can't give up because it is your true calling. You desire to be with your feminine. She represents more than just love. She represents truth and the awakening, you know, of your consciousness. The final piece of the puzzle. The Queen of Swords could represent an air sign. You know, you got the King here. But what I'm seeing is that this is a divine feminine holding that sword of truth, unwavering, even though she's exhausted and wants to give up. She's standing there in her truth. Heart chakra open. The Universe card is a completion of the Fool's journey. It is a final puzzle being laid in place, an ending up to 20-year cycle. She represents that completion for you. And there's a sense that that completion is coming. So I'm seeing union in your reading. The desire for union and movement towards it. Okay, I'm going to look at the bottom of the deck for the overall energy. Nice. Ace of Swords. Making that decision, having mental clarity, cutting away the barriers, the fear, the doubt, the darkness, and standing in your light and being illuminated. Beautiful. So the masculine is holding the sword of truth. Okay. So, I think I'm going to pull the four cards on the side. And I'm going to use the Osho Zen Tarot. So, four cards for the feminine, four for the masculine. Just to see which direction the paths are, you know, leading them towards, or what the paths look like. Okay, so for the feminine, her external environment, awareness, the Chariot, being the awareness, the child, truth is burning away the illusion. And it's basically exactly what I'm picking up from the feminine. you know, offering that awareness, that truth, and essentially it is because of that that the masculine is awakening to his truth as well, seeing through the veil of illusion. The masculine external environment, success and victory, being recognized for your work that you've done in your spiritual growth. But it's an external environment, so it's like a fiery energy that you feel surrounding you, making you feel successful. Feminine internal, Ace of Cups, going with the flow. Yeah, you are. Not only does this mean that it's a new beginning of love, but it is letting go of control and just going with the flow, letting the current take you where it may. Peaceful. The masculine internal, the Tower. So transformation, the Death card, was a shared energy for the twin flame reading. So I'm getting the sense that, you know, you're both need to release this Tower energy on some level. The feminine, although she's being represented in the Divine Masculine reading as being open and allowing, in the Twin Flame reading, there was fears that needed to be addressed. So the Tower card, your internal environment, you know that the Tower must come down if you are to live your true life. Live your authentic life. So, Spirit is asking you to be the conscious observer behind the Tower. The feminine's hopes and fears, Wheel of Fortune again. She would desires change, and she's allowing that change to occur. Accepting of it. Going with the flow, being the conscious observer. Repeated theme. Masculine hopes and fear. Rebel. Divine masculine. You desire freedom, to be free of the chains. Allow that Tower to fall and step into your true power as a divine masculine. Final outcome for the feminine. Completion, that final puzzle piece being placed. Beautiful. Wow, these cards are exactly what the reading, you know, that they're repeated cards. It's crazy. Final outcome for the masculine. Wow, Four of Wands. Seriously. This is the Twin Flame calling card. It is that happy ending. Union, you know, that arrival. It could represent engagement or buying a home, moving, but it's feeling like you've arrived, but yet you have your whole life ahead of you with your twin to enjoy. So because you've allowed that Tower to fall and you've stepped into your power, this union is on the horizon for you. The final piece of the puzzle being placed. So, congratulations to those who resonate strongly with this reading. It's a beautiful reading. So let me know how you feel in the comment section below. And again, thank you so much, guys, for sharing this journey with me. All right, cheers. Peace.